Hey everyone, Thomas from masteringexplained.com here. I am working as a mastering engineer and I've been doing that for more than 20 years. And on this channel, Mastering Explained, me and Sofia are sharing our knowledge about mastering. And there are other mastering engineers on YouTube as well. And one of them is Streaky. And a couple of days ago, he released a really good video about using dynamic EQ for a specific strategy. And he was using a dynamic EQ called Pro-Q3 from FabFilter. And that's an equalizer that I don't have. I don't use it, but it seems very good. I will probably check it out. And then we got a question on one of our videos referencing this video from Streaky, asking if it's possible to do this technique using TDR Nova instead. And that would, of course, be great because TDR Nova is a free plugin. We have a video about that. You can check it out. And the answer is yes, it's very much possible to use this strategy in TDR Nova as well. And we'll get to that in a moment. But first, we need to have a look at this strategy that Streaky is talking about. The goal here is to make a track sound more exciting with more movement and more clarity in the low end and also more sparkle in the high end and more stereo width. There's a lot of things happening using this strategy. And there are mainly two basic strategies involved in this. And the first one is that we want to give the track more low-end clarity, and we do this by using an expander in the lowest frequencies. And we're also cutting out some mids, low mids, by using a compressor in the low mids. So by using expansion in the low end, we can make the low end pop out a bit more. And when we do that, things tend to get a bit muddy, and the muddiness usually resides somewhere in the lower mids. So we can counteract that muddiness by also compressing the low mids. So that's a very clever technique to increase the punch and the clarity in the low end without muddying up the lower mids and without making the lower mids thinner. And the second strategy is that we want to create more width, stereo width, by expanding the high end in the side signal. Okay, the most basic way of increasing width in a stereo signal is to just increase the level of the side signal of the difference channel. We have a video about mid-side if you want to check that out. But if we just increase the level of the side signal, that will also rebalance the mix. It will sound a bit more messy. We will get more reverb, for example, in the mix, and we will basically mess around with the balances within the mix. So that's not the best way to increase the width of a mix. A better way is to use an equalizer in the side channel, in the S signal or difference channel, and only increase certain bands, like for example the high end, using a shelving filter in the side signal. And an even more clever trick is to use an expander in the side signal, expanding only the highest frequency using a shelving filter. And that's what we can see happening in Streaky's video when he's working in the high end of the spectrum. And this technique will accentuate the transients in the high end, and it will make the transients sound wider. And this will make everything sound a bit more exciting and sparkling. And if we combine this strategy with the other strategy where we're getting more punch and clarity in the low end, then we will have something that will make the whole mix sound more exciting. And the main takeaway from Streaky's video, as I see it, is these two strategies. That's what I think is very interesting. It's also very interesting to see him implement that using the Pro-Q3 equalizer, and that's a good thing, but the real value, the gold in this video, is the two strategies that he's showing. And it's the implementation of these strategies that will give you the result that you're after. It's not the tools used, it's the strategies themselves that you can use. And this can be done in many different ways. You can use TDR Nova, which I will show you soon, or you can use, for example, multiplicity from DMG Audio, or pretty much any dynamic EQ where you can use expansion on the bands. That's the key part of this. The strategies themselves are not a one-size-fits-all kind of solution to any problem, but they are very, very useful, and you should really have them in your bag of tricks. So now, let's have a look at how we can do this in TDR Nova. Let's go. Okay, so I will walk you through how to do this in Nova. I thought I would show you the finished example first, so that you can hear what we're aiming for. We need to have two instances of Nova, but I will get to the details shortly. It will sound like this when we're finished. Okay, so we'll start by adding an instance of Nova to the channel. And this is the one where we will do the low end and low mid things. And we will do it only in the mid channel. So we will set the stereo mode to sum. This will make Nova work only on the sum signal, on the M signal, or mid or mono, whatever you would call that. So that's what we want to use. And we also want to disable EQ gain for this example. Then we want to have a look at the first band and use the shelving filter. And we can increase the level of this one to about 1.5 dBs or so. And then use the Q value to make sure that we are reaching into the mid frequencies as well with this. So somewhere around there. You will have to listen to hear what's suitable for your material, but we'll just dial in a starting point now. And in order to make this band into an expander, we will need to enable the dynamics for this band and reduce the ratio to be below 1. So we want to reduce this. I think 0.8 is a good starting point. And then we will adjust the threshold to make things happening. So we'll have a listen. Now we are getting this band to react to the low end, and it will expand the low end. We can twiddle with the attack and release times. I think this will need a bit shorter attack. I think the release time is good, maybe a bit shorter. So we want this to be bouncing along to the music. That's what we want. So that's good for now, and we will move to the next band, which will be the mid compressor, the low mid compressor. So this is where you can add some mids, and we maybe want a bit narrower filter for that. And we can also enable the threshold, and now it is set up as a normal compressor. We have a ratio 2:1, and we can reduce the threshold until it's bouncing along with the music. Maybe reduce the attack time as well. So now we have a sort of starting point. We can have a listen. And you will, of course, tweak these parameters to make it sound good for the material you are working on, but this is a sort of a starting point, and we can disable these two other bands because we're only using these now. So that's what we'll do in this instance. Then we're going to look at the high-end thing. So we'll add another instance of Nova. And now we want to disable all three bands. We want to set it to difference, the difference channel. We're just going to work on the S signal, the side signal, or the difference signal. Different names for the same thing. And we also want to remove this EQ gain as well. And now we're going to work with the highest band only. It's already set as a shelving, and we'll maybe have it at 8 kHz or so. And we will also do this expander thing on this. We will have it at 0.8:1. Maybe a bit shorter attack. We'll see how this reacts. So now this is bouncing along with the music as well. Let's hear it with and without. Okay, so if we combine these two, we can hear the result. Okay, so we get some more movement in the low end, we get some more width in the high end. So this is a good trick. Is this exactly the same as what Streaky was showing in his video? No, it isn't. We're using different tools for this, so there will be different sound. And we also have a lot of settings. We have the attack and release time for each of the bands, so this will also make things sound different. But the point I want to make here is that the tools themselves are not that important. The important knowledge is that you can use these strategies, and how you implement these strategies, that's up to you. But knowing about these strategies, then you can figure out a way to implement them with the tools that you have. Okay? And you can't really have too many of these kinds of strategies. These are great building blocks for setting up a mastering chain for each track that you work with. So if the low end is a bit muddy and static and needs a bit more excitement and movement, then this is a very good trick to make that happen. You can do it in other ways as well. You can remove that one and you can make this one a bit sharper, or you can have that one as a peak filter, or you can remove that and only use this section. You can adjust the gain. There are so many variations of this, but if you know the basic trick, then you can apply that in any situation. The tools that you use to implement the strategies are not that important. They are important, of course, but if you know the strategy and you know why you are doing it and you know your intention with doing them, then you can achieve that with many kinds of tools, okay? So that's how you do this in TDR Nova. We have some great stuff coming up on this channel shortly. Sofia had a great idea about a year ago, which we have discussed and tried to find ways to realize. And it's about developing your hearing, developing your mastering skills, and I think you will find it very interesting. So hit the subscribe button so that you don't miss out on this. We will talk about this shortly. And also hit the like button if you like this video. And thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.